Thank you, David. We are talking about offering care and support during one of the most difficult times for families and their loved ones. From Hospice of the Western Reserve, please welcome pediatric team leader Jen Palmer. And also, we have a local mom who's here to share her experience with Hospice of the Western Reserve, Kelly Ellsworth. Thank you both for being here
today.
Thank you.
Jen,
I want to first start with you because, as humans, we hear the term hospice, and we don't want to almost accept that because that means it's time. That's what we think in our head. But that is not the case. And I think a lot of families wait for wonderful care that they could receive because they're afraid of that notion.
Correct. I think it's one of those things, and especially in pediatric palliative care and hospice, it's a very scary thing as soon as you hear those words of hospice. And so it allows us to provide that opportunity to get in the home, initially start with talking with families about palliative care support. And from that, then they can get to know our team. We can start to get to know the patient and what kind of care and support that we can provide, knowing that we're going to work with their physicians and support whatever decisions a parent needs to make. And I think that's the thing that allows them the comfort to be able to relax. So then that way, when we do get to that point of having to really talk about advancing that level of care to a hospice level of support, then that way the family is ready for it because they know they're not losing their team, they're not losing mm-hmm. their physician. Everyone is there to work with them and really help support what their goals and what their desires are.
And I think it's so important to hear these stories of families who have experienced this firsthand. And Kelly, you've done so with your daughter, Ashlyn. Can I just have you explain your interaction, how it came to be that you relied on Hospice of the Western Reserve?
Well, Ashlyn had a condition that she was born with that we didn't even know what it was until she had passed away. So we didn't find out what she had until she passed away. So Ashlyn was offered hospice and palliative care actually way earlier than what we took Western Reserve up on. So Ashlyn just got to the point where she really needed more care than what her regular doctors were able to give her. And it was just a point where I had to say, okay, we need some more help here. I need somebody to be on our team for what our goals were for our daughter. And I was a little resistant at first, for mm-hmm. sure. She had a palliative team for a long time. But after talking with Jen, I felt very comfortable. I agree with what she was saying. You don't want to go on to hospice. I really fought it for a long time.
Of course.
But it's really not like that. It's actually having more control of what you want for your family member. And it's really like an extended family that you're bringing on going into hospice. So everything was very positive with the experience I had. They were very understanding and were there for us 100%.
Well, and you have to know, when this is a nonprofit organization, this is not a for-profit business here. So you know that these people who are part of this, their hearts are fully invested in what they're doing because they don't have to be doing this work. And so did that give you peace of mind?
Well, I got to be honest, I didn't know about that until the walk this year. So I had no idea. We just have good insurance. So I was like, our insurance is paying for this. We haven't gotten a bill. And I had to ask them a few times, like, are you guys serious that you are a nonprofit organization? And they were like, yes. And I was like, that just seems sad because so many children are in situation that my daughter was in. And I feel like resources need to be available for those families. So the fact that they're doing this, it's an amazing job that they do for families.
And you see this day in and day out. How important is it for people to just understand? I know we're always working to raise money, and for the pediatric realm, when you hear stories like this, I get it, but why do you want people to understand the importance of those donations?
Because care for pediatric patients is a lot different than adult patients. The funding is different because you don't have those same resources. So even when you have Medicare and Medicaid dollars, that a lot of pediatric patients don't get those things. And so we need the additional funding to be able to support a pediatric program. And especially at Hospice of the Western Reserve, our program focuses specifically on the pediatric population. We all have that specialty. behind us so that we can provide our families with the support that they need. And so the money that we're able to receive, it helps with programming in terms of adding those additional things like music therapy, art therapy, just being able to support the families with those, like Kelly said, those resources that sometimes don't get covered by the insurance company. And so you also have families that are still looking towards some of their care that the insurance company has to say, okay, we'll cover, you know, the specialized wheelchair, but we won't cover the hospice level of care. And so that's how those additional funding supports help our team.
It's one of those organizations that you don't know how much you need them until you do need them. And so I highly encourage you to go to hospicewr.org, learn more about it. I've been blown away every time I, you know, with the walks every year and everything that you all do. It's amazing to me, and I know that you've seen it firsthand, and I thank you both so much for sharing your story and for letting us know more about this. They can always go to hospicewr.org to learn more about how, if they're in these situations, their family can be helped as well. Thank you guys
thank
so
you.
Much for being here. Merry
thank
Christmas
you.
To you.
Merry Christmas.